Namo, tasso, bhagavato, arahato, sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha. Indeed. Namo, tasso, bhagavato, arahato, sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha, indeed. Namo, tasso, bhagavato, arahato, sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha, indeed.
Hello again, friends. Another little walk and talk on classic early Buddhist philosophy and praxis, right where it all started, in the jungle. So, one famous statement by the Buddha was Sabbe, sankhārā, dukkhā. Sabbe, all. Sankhārā, constructions. Dukkhā, suffering. All constructions are suffering. What are constructions? Just basically everything that is conditioned, that comes into being by a cause or a set of causes that are constructed, so to speak, by a set of causes, and which therefore also goes out of being, disappears when this set of causes this ceases to be. So, this means that everything that is impermanent, and this was the other statement the Buddha come with, Sabbe Sankhara aniccā, all these constructions, they are not lasting. They are transient. They are coming and going. One cannot trust them. One cannot rely on them, because they are inherently unstable. Inherently, they will go away by nature. And they cannot escape it. Because of that impermanence, this transience of these states, then he said, Sabbe Sankhara aniccā, all constructions, whether internal constructions, physical constructions, or external constructions, whether self or other, whether mental constructions or physical constructions, then they are all the same. They are all impermanent. And because they are impermanent, then one cannot keep them. Because one cannot keep them, then one will eventually feel suffering when losing them. Because of feeling suffering when losing them, one will feel frustration, despair. And that is indeed suffering. That is dukkha. The last statement he gave, he said, was Sabbe Dhamma, all states are no self. Didn't say Sabbe Sankhara, said Sabbe Dhamma. Because this is a state that is not a construction, that is not caused by anything. So it's not an effect of anything. What is that state? That's the state of nirvana. That's not caused by anything. That's not an effect of anything. Because it really is so, then he said, Sabbe Dhamma, all states are no self. States in this regard means a blinking quantum mechanical state that has certain properties and information. We typically divide them into mental states and physical states. But that's how somehow an artificial division, because they are all the same still. They don't have any core. They are empty of self, of me, of core, of ability to exist independently. So they also have no substance if it's material states. Even the mountain I'm going on now, and you see behind you, it has no substance. Because basically, if we take whatever they are made out of, all the atoms they are made out of, and shoot them through a double-slit experiment, as they do in quantum mechanics, then they will be converted into probability. And probability, though real, has no substance or weight or properties whatsoever, except being probable to be measured or to be experienced by an observer. So atoms and everything else that goes with that can be converted into probabilities in experiments. And they are so if unobserved. That's a wave aspect. And therefore they have no substance. That goes true both in Buddhism and in quantum mechanics. And here is a perfect place to do some photographing. Summary. The Buddha said, Sabbe sankhārā aniccā. All constructions are impermanent. Sabbe sankhārā dukkhā. All constructions are therefore, ultimately speaking, suffering. Sabbe Dhamma anattā. All states, past, present, or future, internal, external, physical, as well as mental, are without a self, without a core, without a substance. Thank you.
You heard Bhikkhu Samahita from the Cypress Hermitage on the Knuckles Mountain, Pampalela, Central Hill Country, Sri Lanka. Please subscribe to the Google group Buddha Direct and visit the website whatbuddhasaid.net. May all beings become thus happy thereby. Thank you. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha. As the next Buddha, the noble Arya Ajitamitaya will say, you can come as you like, but you pay as you go. Thank you for your contribution and help. And nice.